Okay, boys, have a cold break. You take one step back. Don't throw any punches to the back of the head. Protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves. Good luck, boys.
A London derby which quite simply has it all. Two youngsters who few outside the trade had on any radar have surprised everyone with this fascinating promotion and build-up. It's captured the imagination. Huge amounts of tickets sold, pride at stake, undefeated records on the line. Lawrence Okolie and Isaac Chamberlain tackle a big battle. 50-50 on paper. It could go any which way. Most feel Okolie, if he's to win, will be knockout within three, four rounds maybe. But if it goes long, will Chamberlain have the ring craft and the know-how to take Okolie into deep water? Compelling.
Got to be very wary of that right hand early doors, has Chamberlain. He wants to get close to Lawrence Okolie and negate the power. When you are up close, the power is much smaller than when you are at range. At this kind of range, Adam, Lawrence Okolie is vicious.
The massive man from Hackney, but the massively dedicated Brixton boy. Who can get it right? Right hand from Okolie. Down goes Chamberlain in the opening minute. And that's the breakthrough that Okolie needed. And there is the power that they've all been talking about.
He knows, Adam. He knows he made a mistake. He pulled out. He pulled straight back. It's a mistake that has put him on the floor here. This is what he needs to do. Make this messy. Tie Lawrence Okolie up.
Hardly any sweat on the Chamberlain body. Was he properly warmed up in the backstage area? He looked nervous and cold before the first bell. And this has woken him right up. The right hands of Okolie.
Lawrence Okolie can't afford to load up or waste much here, Adam. You see, what can happen now is you get over-anxious from the knockdown. Good counter left hook there from Isaac Chamberlain. He's got to be careful, Lawrence Okolie, because the one thing that can happen with such a big puncher is you tire and gas. And that can happen by loading up, looking for the big shot.
And you can't be vulnerable yourself.
Without a shadow of a doubt. He landed that shot, Adam, and there wasn't really much in it, to be totally honest. It was more of a reaction right hand. Isaac is making himself too easy to hit here, and he's putting the hands up instead of slipping.
Big
shot. Shot.
Yeah, good left hand from Okolie, who's had such a fast, furious start here. There's the big range and reach. He just shoves Chamberlain down. No knockdown, but that's the difference in size.
It's the physicality, Adam. It's the physicality of Lawrence Okolie. We have to remember, Lawrence Okolie is a big, big cruiserweight. Very, very physical and strong. And it showed there in the clinch.
It's almost like a small heavyweight in with a medium-sized cruiser.
Yeah, well, to be honest, Isaac Chamberlain isn't a big cruiserweight, but he's very skillful at times and he moves well. He's making himself too easy to hit. I said in the build-up, he cannot afford to shoulder roll in range. He's got to bring himself out of range and make himself harder to hit. It's a mistake that got him put down. He has to eradicate them from his game, Adam.
The jab of Okolie, the spidery arms and the big start for the man from Hackney. Brian O'Shaughnessy in the corner. I wonder what Ted Bammy's thinking about this. Just a glancing shot though.
I said, Adam, he didn't even need to load up. It was there. He's seen the shot, he took it. You know, he didn't load up at all. It's things like this, slight reaction. It's the back of the head even, Adam. It's not even around the push on the chin. What it does is it discombobulates you. It takes away your senses when it's around the back of the head.
What an experienced corner, James Cook. Terrific fighter once upon a time, so too Isaac's uncle Ted Bammy, former European champion.
Very good coach, James Cook.
The black and gold of Lawrence Okolie, the all-white.
Lawrence Okolie just looks so much more relaxed, Adam. He's more relaxed, he's happy in there. Good counter left hook from Chamberlain. He needs to to move more, Adam. For the first four rounds, Isaac Chamberlain shouldn't even be considering exchanging. He needs to take Lawrence Okolie to a place where he hasn't been before as a professional. He's been here, Adam. He's been in these exchanges early doors in the second round. Isaac Chamberlain has got to do something that no other opponents have done to Lawrence Okolie, and that's to try and make it physical, take it to close quarters, and get past five or six rounds.
Attempt to negate those serious advantages that Okolie has. But Okolie was telling us in the week that he's happy to outbox Chamberlain at times and then knock him out. He said that it's all about the talk about Chamberlain's skill. He said, I've got plenty as well. I was the one that went to the Olympics.
To be honest, Adam, he possesses the natural advantages in this fight. He has the height, he has the size, he has the physicality and the strength, and he has the power advantage. That's huge at this weight. For me, Chamberlain's better way is up close, it's inside. I think Chamberlain might be slightly quicker. It just, you know, he's getting caught going in. It's clever from Lawrence Okolie because he's making Chamberlain pay every single time they're out of the clinch.
And he's leaning on him as well.
That weight will show, Adam. You see where he's leaning here? That shows after five or six rounds. Isaac Chamberlain is not used to being in a wrestling match with such a big physical guy, especially on fight night. He might be used to that in the gym and sparring, but he isn't used to this on fight night. That was low from Lawrence Okolie.
Joe Joyce, who's ringside with David Hay, was saying that Lawrence Okolie is so difficult to read. 1 point off for holding already from Steve Gray.
Was there any warning before that? I think that's a little bit harsh from Steve Gray. There was no warning, there was no, you know, straight away a point. That's a bit much, in my opinion, but we'll see. He's doing what he needs to do here, Isaac Chamberlain. He's making it messy. He's getting up close. He's not giving Lawrence Okolie much target to find, and he's making him miss at him. Let's just remember that now. We have 30 seconds left in round two, and Lawrence Okolie is being made to miss.
Yeah, that could come into play later on, but it's been a bit of a nightmare start this for Isaac Chamberlain. Found himself on the floor in the first. Not a big punch landed, but he was down and counted, and now he's had a point taken off as well. Okolie just trying to drill these shots home. But how will he cope round after round? Because he's so inexperienced as a pro.
I think he's cut. He's got a slight nick over his left eye, as Isaac Chamberlain. It's just a graze, a little nick, but there's a little bit of blood coming from it.
They've worked for weeks, for months, on a tactical game plan, Team Chamberlain. But it's Lawrence Okolie who's had the much brighter start here to this cruiserweight clash at the O2, the vacant WBA Continental belt on the line. But it's much more than that. This is a gateway to the big time, to really trying to dominate this cruiserweight division. It's so exciting at the moment.
Forget about the big time, Adam. This is for territory. This is a derby. This is up close and personal. This is for who's the King of London. That's what this is all about.
Time out again. Steve Gray wants it tidied up. So much has been spoken. Huge tension.
Regardless of what's been said, there is mutual respect between these two guys. I can absolutely guarantee that. They both know the quality guys in the beginning of both of their careers. I think both these guys are going to learn massively from tonight and will both go on to win numerous titles.
This is when Isaac Chamberlain had that disaster against Wadi Camacho when his shoulder popped out and dislocated, and he got through that.
He did.
Somehow, that was incredible.
He's getting a bit more confident now, Adam. He's looking to sting Lawrence Okolie with them heavy jabs. He's going in behind the heavy front foot and looking to land stingful jabs. So he's obviously confident back in his ability. He's got his legs back about him, but he's lost 4 points in two rounds, Adam. You know, I've got it scored 20-16 because he's suffered two 10-8 rounds. One because of the holding, the other one because of the knockdown.
Well, you can't argue with that at all. Chamberlain trying to let his hands go. He's got those thick legs. which normally suggests a decent chin. He's not a big puncher, though, Chamberlain, although they've been working on that area, and he has had a few stoppage wins of late, but in this class now with Akoli, can he find something to trouble the big man?
What he lacks in punch power, Adam, he makes up for in bravery. As we saw that night against Roddy Camacho, the shoulder popping out would have been a very valid reason for any fights to stop. Good left hook to body there from Isaac Chamberlain. It would have been a valid reason to stop, but that night he bit down on the gum shield and he found a way.
Flicking in the jab, there's the left hook as well. Getting closer, Chamberlain, but Coley tries again to shove him back.
I think he felt that, Adam. I think Isaac Chamberlain felt that left hook from Akoli. It was a short, cuffing shot that came out of the vision of Isaac Chamberlain. It's what I talk about in the build-up. Lawrence Akoli throws shots that are very awkward and come out of the line of eyesight, and he's just seemed to have clipped Isaac Chamberlain with a left hook there.
These big clubbing punches. That's a right hand to the top of the head as well by Akoli. There's a confidence in his work. Chamberlain tries to get back with a left hand. He needs something to work. He's being shoved around. He's physically suffering too. Welcome back. The talking over. The fighting very much underway, and it is advantage Lawrence Akoli. He's just a little bit lost in there, Isaac Chamberlain.
He does. I said at the start, he looks very nervous tonight, but he's got through three rounds, Adam. He knows a couple more, and then this fight starts to edge more towards him. He is definitely getting more confidence. He's throwing punches now, so, you know, we're through three rounds. But
he's 5 points behind on your unofficial card. Remember, the knockdown and the point off as well.
He is 5 points down, Adam, but I don't think in James Cook's game plan or Ted Bami's game plan he ever saw this fight go in the distance. And I believe they're looking at coming into this fight in the second half of this fight. They're going to want to draw this thing out to Lawrence Akoli. They're going to want to take him to a place he hasn't been before. And that's past six rounds. We know Isaac Chamberlain can do it. He's been there, he's proven it. Can Lawrence Akoli? This is the big question.
Yep, at the moment, he's answering questions, Akoli. He's dominating this fight, but it is early still.
Good body shot from Lawrence Akoli on the inside there. Isaac Chamberlain dipped low, and he didn't see it coming under. He's got to be careful as he's coming out of these clinches here, Isaac Chamberlain, because Lawrence Akoli's power is devastating at mid-range. He has to be close as he's coming out here. Steve Gray's in between them this time, but that's not always going to be the case. He's bending low and he can't see what's coming at him. He's got to keep his eyes on Lawrence Akoli at all times if he's going to have any success. He's making this messy here. Steve Gray's having to get more involved than we'd like to see. You know, Steve needs to let them fight on the inside, in my opinion, a little bit more. You know, let them work the way out of there.
That's what Chamberlain will want, yes, to try and negate those big arms of Akoli. Get inside, land a few body shots. He just hasn't established any sort of rhythm at all, Chamberlain. And the rounds are ticking by.
Isaac Chamberlain isn't spent yet. He hasn't used much energy. He hasn't thrown any big shots. He hasn't really had to exhaust himself in any way. Lawrence Akoli is being very physical, throwing big shots, going to head and body. He's initiating all the physical game plan here. Isaac Chamberlain is doing very little, Adam. If he gets past four and a half rounds, this is going to be a difficult fight for Lawrence Akoli. It really is.
Just looked in his corner there, Isaac Chamberlain, as if to say, what am I doing here? It's not going according to any sort of plan, unless he just is hoping that he gets to round six or seven and suddenly Akoli tires and comes apart.
Is Isaac Chamberlain, Adam, sticking to a game plan that has been created by his two coaches rather than himself? Is he going through a moment here where he's asking his coaches, I don't agree with this, and he's looking at them as if to say, I shouldn't be doing this? So is he now going to try and take matters into his own hands? I don't know.
Again, it's messy, it's scrappy.
Steve Gray telling him he will throw both guys out if they continue to make this scrappy.
jab from Okoli. There's the space for the right hand, and that was a rough and rugged round.
It's the round that Chamberlain wants, Adam. It's the round that he needs.
Move around it. Use the jab. Move.
The physicality of Lawrence Okoli. Such a major factor in this.
It is. He's a big, big cruiserweight, Adam. He's bigger than me. He's a big, big guy who carries a big punch. But with them attributes, there must become another side to it. He's going to tire, Adam. He loads on shots. He does what he's doing. He's got to be careful that he hasn't loaded too much and too many times.
It's already halfway through. He's got up off his stool quickly, Lawrence Okoli. No sign of it yet. It's up to Team Chamberlain to change this around, because it's one-sided at the moment. Lawrence Okoli calls himself Sauce, or the Penny Boy. His bunch of friends and the jar of pennies went all over the floor, and they picked one out and said, this is going to be our direction in life. This is how we're going to make our money. And he chose boxing.
One thing I will say for Lawrence Okoli is he's handling himself very well here. He's trying to box, he's trying to use the range, and he's looking to set up the shot. I haven't seen him doing this before. Don't get me wrong, he still looks raw. He still technically looks as if he isn't as good as Isaac Chamberlain. But he's making the most of what he's got.
Has been six rounds against Blaise Mendu at the York Hall. Got some criticism for that, but he's blown away pretty much everybody quickly. That's the thing with Lawrence Okoli. So we just weren't quite sure how good or how well he's adapted as a pro because of that.
Chamberlain is now getting close and isn't holding. He's trying to get his hands free to let go. It seems to be Okoli who's initiating the holding now. You know, you're going to see as this fight goes on, one fighter get more confident and another fighter tired. I'm adamant that Okoli can't maintain this pace. He cannot maintain to throw these power shots the way he is. It does have an effect that it drains you, it tires you.
The old saying in boxing, does a good big un beat a good little un most of the time?
He does usually, but when the little guy is expending very little energy at him, or is putting very little into the punches so far, like I said, that can have a drastic change as we go further down the line. He's making him miss again, Adam. So far, he's not making him pay. He's just making him miss. Like I said before, is the game plan for Isaac Chamberlain to keep drawing the sting from Lawrence Okoli? Is he going to put his foot on the gas? Because right now, he has to win every single round to win this fight on points. So he's obviously got everything banked on a late knockout. He has to, because right now, he's lost this fight on points if it goes to points.
Either that, or he's a bit lost in a haze and just can't cope with the physical strength of Lawrence Okoli. We're not sure what's going on in Isaac Chamberlain's mind and in the tight-knit team of Ted Babby and James Cook in that red corner alongside us. They look worried, they look frustrated in the corner.
Isaac's shocked by the physical strength of Lawrence, the size. He's imposing his whole demeanour. He's the boss in here so far, Adam. You know, after four rounds, he's the boss. It's as simple as that. He's making Isaac just, there's nothing. Isaac's making Lawrence miss, but he's not making him pay in any way. And there is no good in just making someone miss all night if you're going to not make them pay for it.
He's turned to the boss. You picked Chamberlain beforehand. David Hay picked Okoli. He's with Andy.
Yeah, thanks, Adam. David, great to see you looking so well here at ringside. Thanks for joining us. How are you seeing this one so far? What have you made of the opening few rounds?
Okoli has won every second of the fight so far. Chamberlain, whatever his game plan, it's out the window and he's in there just surviving. It looks so awkward and it's not a boxing match, and that's what Chamberlain can't get to grips with. He can't get to the grips with Okoli's long arms, long legs. He's tying him up, he's pushing him, he's leaning on him. He's so physically strong, he's sapping all of Chamberlain's energy. So whatever, I can see Chamberlain's corner so frustrated, screaming instructors, streaming to throw three or four punch combinations. He can't throw one. He's not in a position to throw punches because Akoli's is literally all over him, and he's giving him no time to think, breathe. It's a great game, but it's not pretty on the eye, but it's effective. He's won every second of every round.
Thanks, David.
I completely disagree. He's not zapping Isaac Chamberlain's energy because he hasn't done anything to be zapped. If anybody's tiring, it's going to be Log Toccoli. This is the kind of fight he wants. He, in my opinion, Isaac Chamberlain has come out here and he's going to start throwing punches now, because it's now in the fight that he sees that this half of the fight is his chance.
I agree with David, though, that he hasn't won anything yet at all, Isaac Chamberlain. Second half, there's certainly a spring to his step, Chamberlain. A corner have either woken him up, or this is the game plan, that this is the time now to take the fight right to Akoli. He's trained so hard, Chamberlain, getting up at 4 or 5 o'clock every morning, doing his runs, going off social media.
That's the first right hand we've seen him throw at him so far tonight. He's not zapped. What it is he's waiting for his moment, and he's had to endure a very physical man leaning on him, pushing him back, but he hasn't had to use his physical game in any way, shape or form yet.
Physical and awkward. I mean, a novice, yes, but you think of sort of Deontay Wilder's type of style, you know, difficult to read and gangly. And
look at what we're watching, Adam. Who's the guy who's backing up now? Chamberlain is starting to walk forward. He hasn't walked forward once all night. He's now walking forward. He's now initiating when the attacks take place.
Tony, he has to have any chance.
Of course he does, Adam, but he knows that he couldn't have done this early doors, because he can't afford to walk onto one from Ron Zaccoli. If what I suspect he's doing now happens, then he's banking all on a stoppage in these next 4 or 5 rounds. Good body shots.
Yep. Body shots are good. Inside. They're tying each other up. Steve Gray gives them room.
Good left hook there on the inside from Chamberlain. Lawrence doesn't seem affected or deterred at all by Isaac Chamberlain's power. That has its good points and bad points. The good points to it is he will continue to walk in. The bad point is he's going to take unnecessary punishment when he's trying to walk through Isaac Chamberlain. So Isaac Chamberlain needs to make... Oh, good right hand, he's touched down.
Yeah, big
shot.
That's
a knockdown.
Glove touchdown, and that's another big problem for Isaac Chamberlain. There's the difference,
he knows,
not just in physicality, but in power.
He's only been down because of his own personal mistakes. He threw a left hook there and pulled out with his chin in the air. That's why he got caught with that big right hand. It's the little mistakes, and this happens in the earlier parts of your career. This is, like I said, a learning fight for both. But Lawrence Okoli's power is the deciding factor here so far.
Of course it is. It's education, and both can come back or on from this. But it is Lawrence Okoli's night so far. It's not been pretty, as David Hay said, but it's been pretty effective. They are running out of time.
He's 9 rounds down, Adam. You know, he had 60-51 for me. He's in trouble. He knows he needs a knockout. Like I've said before, this has always been the game plan for Isaac Chamberlain. I just think he didn't envisage 2 knockdowns being involved in this fight. So Ron Toccoli doesn't visibly look tired to me, which is a good sign. Isaac Chamberlain is in a lot of trouble here, because now he has to come out and force the fight, and that may play into Ron Toccoli's hands. Ron Toccoli shaking his head here at the start of the round, looking at Isaac Chamberlain as if to say, I told you, boy, I told you so.
Yep, I've got you. It's round 7. It's the first time that he's heard the bell, Lawrence Toccoli, for this, but at the moment he looks fresh as a daisy. Boxing to his plan, and let's give Brian O'Shaughnessy and the team credit, because the power and the strength has worked, and Isaac Chamberlain is in a whole heap of trouble here.
Big right hand, he's here, big there. Isaac Chin, a right hand to the side of his temple, just left him a little bit off balance. He knows now, Isaac Chin, he's got to get close and make Okoli pay for any mistakes, but every time he steps into range, he's getting hit at him. Even the jabs look to be hitting him.
Fraser Clark, the heavyweight with the amateurs, said that Lawrence Okoli punches like a heavyweight, and Joe Joyce was saying he's so awkward, and he's going to be like that, isn't he, to fight as an opponent?
He is. He's a nightmare to prepare for, Lawrence Okoli, because he is the size of a fully-fledged heavyweight, and he punches like one also, but he has the speed and nimbleness of a cruiserweight. So, you know, he has some fantastic attributes to his game. I just feel Isaac hasn't worked when he's made a miss tonight. And he's, you know, now that he's in a position where he has to press, it's not his kind of game plan. It's not what he's good at. You know, he looks the smaller man. He's feeling everything here. Lawrence has shown great levels of stamina at him. He's pressed this fight from the get-go. He's made it physical, and he is not tired.
Great levels of stamina. Great levels of perseverance. And he's flowed much more than Isaac Chamberlain. Not yet has been the classic we all hoped for, but it has been intriguing all the way through, watching what's next. But you're just sort of looking as a neutral for something for Chamberlain to get hold of, some sort of breakthrough, and it just hasn't happened at all.
It just feeling everything, Adam. It's hard for him. This is a hard, hard night for him. It's a great learning fight, but it's hard. You know, the bigger guy is imposing his will, using his strength, his size to benefit him.
Chamberlain was saying Okoli needs to answer the questions. I've done it against Wadi Camacho and others, and Okoli hasn't. Well, he is tonight. He's showing us something here, Lawrence Okoli.
He is. He's showing he can win and win ugly, Adam. That's what he's showing here tonight. This isn't a spectacle by any means, but what it is it's a great lane. He's getting rounds in. He's facing an opponent. Like I say, we're seeing him on the back foot here, Lawrence Okoli. I said pre-fight, can he do it on the back foot? Well, he's showing us he can, because this is the first time he's been asked.
Welcome back. Well, it's not been the action we all really hoped for before the first bell, after the major build-up and anticipation. But it has been really effective work from Lawrence Okoli to negate pretty much everything Isaac Chamberlain has done. Has he landed any really meaningful punches, Chamberlain? He's tried, but it's the big guy in Okoli and that extra power. And look at this, the ring intelligence, actually, that he's showing tonight to get the win at all costs. He's got 9 minutes under Chamberlain to turn this right around. He is miles, miles behind on the cards. Look at this, the takes loose on the left glove, and he appears ragged too, Tony.
He is, Adam, because you know what he's doing now? He's doing things he's never had to do in his career. He's having to press now. He's having to force the issue because he knows he's a mile behind. He knows he needs the knockout, and he's trying to do it, but it's not in his repertoire. He hasn't practiced for this kind of fight, Adam. He thought Lawrence Okoli was going to keep coming all night, make the same mistakes, keep falling in. And if anything, he's the guy who now is being made to reach. He's the guy who's being made to pay for the mistakes.
And stamina great from Okoli as he looks for an uppercut there. The wiry arms and that terrifically long reach being very effective. You know, he's throwing the right hands, now he's trying the uppercuts on the inside. You know, it's been a good performance this from Lawrence Okoli. As we said, not pretty, but really good.
As I said, Adam, winning is winning. You don't always need to win pretty, you just need to win. And tonight, Lawrence Okoli has learned, well, he's learning to win ugly, as we all have to do on some occasions.
Yet we remember one or two of your earlier escapades.
Too many to remember, Adam. I can only apologise to the viewers watching now.
Thank God it's got better of late.
Thankfully.
Chamberlain trying to land a body shot, but he's breathing heavier now.
He's trying to make a fight of this, Adam. but he's just, he doesn't have the physicality to impose himself on Lauren Toccoli. And to be honest, he's just not feeling any of these Lauren Toccoli.
Only four knockouts in his nine wins, the 23-year-old Isaac Chamberlain. It was always the worry when he turned pro in the first couple of fights we saw him that he wouldn't quite have the power to be able to go through the levels, but he's done well. He's got himself this opportunity. Will he be kicking himself tomorrow morning, or will he just say, look, he was just too big and too awkward for me?
He's had to find that out the hard way tonight, but, you know, the cruiserweight division is a difficult one because there's guys who are just too big for light heavyweight, and then there's guys that are slightly too small for heavyweight. So there's divisions within a division in the cruiserweight division. It's hard to explain, but like I said, there is guys who are slightly too big for light heavyweight and guys who are slightly too small for heavyweight. So, like, it's two stone now, the best part of two stone from light heavyweight to cruiserweight. And we're seeing here a guy who just is a little bit too much for light heavyweight, and a guy who can boil himself down to cruiserweight, and it's showing tonight.
Don Toccoli, part of Anthony Joshua's promotional stable. Let's hear from AJ with Andy.
Thanks, Adam. AJ, you picked Toccoli beforehand and you're being vindicated now. What have you made of it so far?
I think he's winning the rounds for sure. Only God knows what they're going through in that ring in terms of emotions. But in terms of, like, entertainment, I think what people want to see is them standing a foot apart and just letting their shots go. And I can get that because when I'm watching, I want a bit more boxing finesse. But that's what happens sometimes. When you've got two styles that, let's say, aren't gelling well, they're sitting on each other's chest and working around the body. But I do feel that there's enough time to still get a knockout. But in terms of entertainment, I think what we wanted to see is a bit more rangy boxing, that jab, that 1-2, that comeback with a left hook, a bit of blood. And I think that's what we haven't got right now. But there's still a few rounds left, so we can still see if Lawrence gets that knockout because he's hurt Isaac a few times.
Thanks, AJ.
Yeah, good point from Anthony Joshua. It's frustrating. It's been a difficult watch because we all hope for more drama, more quality, really. But he's right. Lawrence Toccoli is winning the rounds. Will there be any drama late on? Two more to go. For Isaac Chamberlain, it is, well, everything that he has to try and muster up. And mentally, what's he thinking at the minute? He's just got to go for broke, hasn't he?
Big right hand there from Lauren Toccoli. Just as Isaac's slipping, as I said before, there's a lot more target to hit when you're a cruiserweight. You know, it's okay slipping, rolling, using the shoulder roll. Floyd Mayweather can use the shoulder roll so effectively because he's small, because he's got a low center of gravity. A cruiserweight is still a big target even on shoulder rolling, and it's just been shown there by Isaac Chamberlain.
Got caught betwixt and between as well, and not able to deal with the power of Toccoli, who's still light on his feet, showing us all that he can do these rounds, Lawrence Toccoli.
Isaac once again showing the heart of a lion, sticking in there. You know, he's now taking heavy punches. He's still trying at them, but the size is just too much. It really, really is.
Of course, he's trying. He doesn't know any other way. He's been trying so hard to make a big splash on the boxing scene. Take nothing away from that desire. But it's all gone wrong for Team Chamberlain tonight. And we've got to say it, Tony, unfortunately, it's not been the classic we hoped for.
No, you know, the style that Isaac came into the ring with was obviously to get close and negate Lauren Toccoli's, you know, power game. But when he's got close, he's just been out-muscled. He's just not been physical enough and strong enough to do anything to Lauren Toccoli up close, and that's been the big factor tonight. I thought he would get up close at him and be able to make it messy and be able to hit Lawrence Toccoli for fun, but he hasn't been able to because Lawrence has just been too strong, too big, and too much.
And you wonder whether there'll be any difference if they fought again in a year's time or so. Isaac Chamberlain, you know, can't really go down. He certainly can't the light heavyweight. As you said, there's a massive difference now. 12-7, 14-4. It's not the 13-8 days, although Okoli has had a point taken off.
It's the best part of two stone, Adam. There is two divisions in the cruiserweight division. I'm a big cruiserweight, I can deal with this. But I feel for Isaac because he's not.
He's stuck.
You know, he can't make light heavyweight. You know, I think Isaac Chamberlain could probably, if he wanted to, get down to around about 13 stone. But then, you know, he'd have to dry out, etc., etc. But very, very hard for the guy.
Ted Bamby looks bemused. Drake's cooking there. I wondered if the nerves beforehand were a really good sign, or I wonder if he sort of deep down thought this was a big arse. It's dawned on him round after round, Isaac Chamberlain. Your heart sort of goes out for him because he's wanted this so much, and he got the platform, the 8,000 people, he got everything he's asked for. But our attention turns to how well Lawrence Okoli has dealt with this as well, because many questions beforehand, many people saying he's delivering a dominant performance like this.
He is, Adam, and you know, I said in the build-up to this, a lot of questions will be asked tonight and we will get the answers. We have got the answers. Lawrence Okoli can do the distance fine. Lawrence Okoli can adapt and box on the back foot. Lawrence Okoli isn't vulnerable. He has got a good chin. Lawrence Okoli's power is there throughout a fight. So we've seen a lot of questions answered by Lawrence Okoli tonight. I'd like to know how much the struggle is to get to the cruiserweight, because I think that might be a factor going down the line. But for now, he looks to be making it fantastically well because he's still energetic, still up on his toes in the 10th and final round here.
At 6'5", surely his future will lie in the heavyweight division in a few years' time. As Isaac Chamberlain tries to take it to him, but Okoli still fresh as a daisy in the 10th round, and that's impressive.
If Lawrence chooses to go to heavyweight heaven, he will encounter the same problems Isaac Chamberlain is encountering tonight. The smaller man, the less physical man. He will give away the attributes that he really needs at cruiserweight.
I know you're a heavyweight as an amateur, but you went up from light heavy as a pro. Anything's possible.
It is, of course, and you can never write this guy off. He has such a big punch, such a big heart. Great to see from both fighters here.
Fighting till the end as well, Isaac Chamberlain, fighting the losing battle, knowing he's a mile behind, but still sticking in there. That's the respect and the pride.
Very unorthodox body punch from Isaac, from Lawrence Okoli there. Just a heavy left up to the body, it's thrown from a crazy angle. He just nodded at me there, he looked down as if to say, you were wrong tonight. But listen, fair play, he's done the right things tonight. His power's been the difference, his strength, his size, his physicality, everything has come and clicked the right time. A good body shot from Lawrence Okoli there. He's just forcing Isaac Chamberlain to the corner here.
Again, Isaac Chamberlain looking at his corner, shaking his head. It's just been a real nightmare for him. But you've got to give Lawrence Okoli credit. Still throwing the big punches late on in the last 30 seconds or so. Said he'll give us the knockout. Doesn't look like it will happen. Chamberlain's intent on surviving to hear the final bell.
15 seconds to go.
15 rounds before tonight. 10 ticked off for Lawrence Okoli, who's been too big, too strong, too powerful, too relentless. It may have been ugly, but he's won, and he's won by a mile.
I'd like to see respect shown by both guys, you know. He's laughing. He knows what he's done. Lawrence Okoli had a lot of people to prove wrong tonight. He knows what he wanted to do. He's gone in there and done it. Congrats to Lawrence Okoli.
looks a forlorn figure in the corner, doesn't he, Isaac Chamberlain? It'll be a long wait for those scorecards, and they will be horrible to hear for the Brixton team. But it will be joy for the Hackney and Penny boys, for the man who was flipping burgers and watching Anthony Joshua win Olympic gold, who dedicated himself to the sport. And on the big stage, and the first big test of his boxing career, Lawrence Okoli passes. He gets through, and he gets through well. Just a shame it wasn't the action-packed fight we'd hoped for.
It can't always be that, Adam. It's it was still, you know, it was a physical chess match. It wasn't the fireworks that we wanted, no, but a lot of people and a lot of questions have been answered tonight. He's gone in there and he's proven a lot of people wrong. He's done exactly what I said he wouldn't do.
He's just having a word with you, I think.
I didn't catch what he said, but he probably said, you got it wrong, and I did. I hold my hands up. I got it wrong tonight. Good to see respect shown.
Absolutely. Let's hear it officially. It's going to be wide, very wide.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of championship boxing, the judges' scorecards read 98, 89, 96, 90, 97, 89, and all three judges are in favour of the winner and the new WBA Continental Cruiserweight Champion from Hackney, East London, Sir Lawrence Okoli.
8-0. The biggest win so far for Lawrence Okoli. Very wide on two cards. Won by just six, but no doubts it was pretty emphatic.